guys, back home, and now I'm gonna tell you visually what I meant by preparing for a difficult trek. Now there are lots of difficult treks in our country. There are numerous: Rupin Pass, Buran Ghati, Chadar Trek, Pin Parvati Pass, and then there is Everest Base Camp, Annapurna Base Camp in Nepal. So because we have so many difficult treks, it's because of the Himalayas. We have the Himalayas, and the Nepal has the Himalayas, and China also. But yeah, there are lots of difficult treks in India. Now, how to prepare for these treks? Let's discuss it visually. So guys, ye chart maine prepare kiya hai so that I can tell you tips to prepare for a difficult trek in India. So Rupin Pass, a very famous crossover trek from Uttarakhand to Himachal. Then there is Buran Ghati. It's also a very good trek, and there is almost 100 meter glide, like wahan se aap fall karte hain. So it's a very exciting trek. Photos mein to bahut exciting lagta hai. The third trek is Stock Concrete Trek. Now this trek is in the region of Ladakh, and Ladakh is famous for Himalayas, mountains, and everything ever beyond. Fourth trek is Goechala Trek. Now this region, Sikkim region, is not that famous for treks, but has the third highest peak, that is Kanchenjunga. And yeah, the mountains in this region are kind of sacred, and people don't really do treks in these regions that often. Another very famous trek is the Everest Base Camp. Now I don't have to mention anything about Everest. It's very famous. It takes about 17 days to reach the base camp, and it's about 17,000 feet. The last that I know, and there are a lot of other treks also, Pin Bhabha, Parvati Pass, there are a lot of treks. Annapurna Circuit Trek and Base Camp Trek. Now this is also in the region of Nepal. Very famous trek. Annapurna mountains are said to be the trickiest mountains, and the base camp is also a great trek to do. Hi guys, first requirement should be your BMI should be under 26. Now if you are new and don't know what BMI is, just Google it out. There is also a BMI calculator just built in the Google search. So BMI should be less than 26. Now for my, if you want to know my BMI, my BMI is 22, which is a perfectly fine BMI. Your BMI should be between 18.5 to 25, not beyond 25. That means you are unfit to trek. And if you have a BMI under 18.5, you can go for treks, but there is some problem in you still there. Second thing you should take care of, that you must run. If you're not a jogger, if you're not someone who walks, and you'll just like in last 5 years you have never walked, just don't think of a difficult trek. Go for a simple hike of 1 or 2 days, and then you will know where you stand. So for those who run, my suggestion is run for 5 kilometers under 30 minutes. So about 6 minutes goes for 1 kilometer. For my personal, I can cover 2 kilometers in 7 minutes, which I recorded just today. I recorded once 5 kilometers in 20-25 minutes, but that was 3-4 months ago, and I'm way fitter than that now. So 3.5 minutes. So 3.5 minutes is what I take to cover up 1 kilometer now. Third thing guys is that you should stair climb. Now this is something not very usual in Indian system. We don't do that anymore, but believe me, your body needs it. And you have to stair climb. Even at metros, I don't use elevator and only use stairs, and you should too. Why use elevator? Use at least stairs if you don't work out at all in a day. So my recommendation is at least do 3 stories before going on a difficult trek. 3 times a day, 3 stories, 3 times a day with 15 kgs backpack on your shoulders. So I don't know, 3 times is less, I guess. Just boost it to 7 times. So you should be able to do a 3-story stair climb 7 times a day with 15 kgs of backpack on your shoulders. So this should be at least your goal before going to a difficult trek. However, this term is not very recommended. We call that rucksack in trekking communities. You should get along with this word rather than a backpack, because you have to carry at least 45 to 50 liter of a rucksack on a difficult trek, 7 to 8 days trek. Now, fourth thing I must say that is very important for your legs is squats. Oh, where is that U? Squats, very important. Why did I do that? So yeah, I meant booty, but surely squats is not just for booty, it's for your inner core strength of your legs. And it's very important on trek that you do, you know, you just start squatting at least a month before a difficult trek. Also, fifth and not the least recommended thing, but also one of the most recommended thing is eat clean. Not because you are going on a trek, because on a trek there are various changes that your body goes through and you're not ready for it if your stomach is not ready for it. So make sure you eat clean at least 15 days before going to a trek. Just stop the junk food, eat home food and eat something even better. If you can, just join a gym for real strength training, because without gym, without the equipment, without dumbbells, you are not ready. Your body is not ready really. So I am regularly gymming and I am going for a difficult trek this first week of June. I'm not gonna tell you which one. So the content will be there, the videos will be there. Alright guys, these are my 6 points that you should follow going on a difficult trek. Also, one point that I forgot, and 7 is actually my lucky number, so I'm gonna include this anyway, is that prepare for a trek, not just physically but mentally. So you have to prepare for a trek mentally, that you're going out for 7-8 days. This is a very important point, because on a trek you're going for 7-8 days, you will miss your family, your friends. So you have to prepare mentally that you're going for 7-8 days to enjoy nature, to push your physical limits, and be prepared mentally. So this point is actually holds the ground for all the 6 points above. If you're not prepared mentally, then you will lose it no matter on what day, first, second, third, or even on 4th day in the middle of mountains. You are losing it, you are missing your family. So just prepare for it that 7-8 days you have no connection with the outside world. You're with your fellow trekkers, so talk with them, enjoy with them. You're on a trek, you're on a vacation. So hope you like this video guys, and if you did, thumbs up the video, share the video and subscribe to my channel Life of Naman for more awesome content. Now I make these videos with a lot of love guys, so hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye bye guys, peace out.